look at me. Who am I supposed to be? I'm Luca Sakoskin, producer, co-writer, and star of The Doorman. Coming soon on theater, July 18, Village East, and hopefully other ones more. So hopefully you come see it. Tell your friends, tell your parents, tell your relative, tell your dogs, tell anyone to come see it. We're here with Barryz, a very famous person for being thrown out of nightclubs.
Hola, señoritas y señores. Yo es Barryz with Lucas Akaskin, filmmaker from The Doorman, right?
Correct.
And it's about what?
A doorman.
Just a doorman?
A special doorman.
Uh-huh. And if you've been kicked out of places like me by doorman, then you should see this movie, right? It'll tell you how to get in those places under the velvet ropes, right?
Yes, and if you haven't been kicked out, you should see the movie anyway.
Yes, because it's incredibly funny and the best movie I've seen in years. We'll be right back after these messages. So how do you get into these places?
Well, you know, once in a little thing that like this, and you can then you can in.
Yeah. Furthermore, you're a Jew too, a Spanish Jew, right?
A Spanish Jew.
Wow. Baruch Hashem.
Baruch Hashem to you.
Muchas gracias.
Muchas de nada.
Buena suerte.
Buenas noches.
Like and Dios.
Yeah, you too.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Ciao.
Hi, it's Barryz from the Barryz Show at the home of Gigantic Pictures with Lucas Akaskin, right?
Yes, how you doing?
Is that a Spanish name?
It's from South America.
You were born in South America?
I was, in Argentina.
Argentina, don't cry for me, Argentina.
Exactly, that was perfect.
Uh-huh. And I heard you're a metrosexual, is that true?
Depends who judge, but yes.
What is a metrosexual?
I don't know. That's why I say
that. They call you that in the movie.
Yes, in the movie, I can come out as many different things. It depends who I have to appeal to.
Okay, I was thinking maybe I could be in the show. You know, like,
yeah.
Let me put it that way.
Like one of the five guys?
No, let me put it that way. Clear eye and straight guy, okay? So,
wait a minute.
Clear eye? Yeah, you're the clear eye, and I'm the straight guy.
Well,
you know?
Trevor, I mean, my God, come on. I mean, that's like, first of all.
But don't tell me that's not genius.
You don't even have the name of the show, right?
What do you mean?
Queer Eye for the Straight Guy.
Queer Eye.
Queer Eye.
Okay, well, whatever.
Queer Eye.
You can have the eye, and I'm the straight guy. Yeah.
I know, but Trevor, but... First of all, they do background checks, so you're not, I mean, you can't just...
I don't do only background. Straight. I only do, like, leads. I don't do background.
Straight guys don't wear turquoise outfits with letters on them. It's like, give me a break.
I thought that was, like...
What are you talking about?
Like, cool. Like, look, it matches.
Like, it definitely matches. Are they pajamas?
No. This is from India, and this is from Brooklyn.
Now, you're the co-writer, producer, and star of The Doorman, right?
Correct.
Tell me what the story is about.
The story is about a nightlife doorman from New York who basically his rise and falls, who really believe on basically the way, and basically the story is about how this character is and what the perspective of life that he has, how he sees life through his eyes. And it's a documentary film crew following his life, basically. And it's a moment where he loses his job And then it's the question on the movie is, what is a doorman without a door? It's just a man. So that's the trigger of the movie, basically. A guy like this, who is accustomed to be living on the top of his life, on the top of what he considers to be a normal life, full of glamour and luxurious and celebrities and that kind of lifestyle. And then all of a sudden, all that vanish. So how he can manage to continue having that lifestyle without being an ador anymore.
Tell me what you think. I was thinking that I could be an actor. I could be a movie star.
You're funny. Sure. You're a funny guy.
I am funny. I do comedy great. Like, I'm so good. I could drama too. I could do drama. I can cry if you want.
You're serious.
Yeah, I can be really serious. Like,
you're not acting. You're playing yourself. This is it. You said it to me.
No,
yourself.
Well, this is it.
It's a cartoon. There's a cartoon about dancing furniture. You want to be in a cartoon? You want to be a
I student? Actually like the idea. I mean, did the church speak or something like that?
You don't speak with a Latin accent. It takes place in London. I apologize.
That's actually pretty funny. That actually is pretty funny because I was thinking I would practice it. Listen that one, eh? Window.
What?
I just gave you an English accent. Again, listen close. Window.
I don't even know what word you're saying. Look, you're not
like
an
window.
Actor.
I'm saying window.
Window?
We shot it 2 years ago, and it took maybe 6 months in and out to shoot. We shot in 7 different cities. And
what cities did you shoot in?
We shot at New York, LA, Miami, San Francisco, Las Vegas, Utah, and I may be forgetting someone else, but most of those cities we shot. And it's present time.
Why is it called a doorman?
Because he's a doorman, and that was the most we couldn't avoid. We thought on one moment to call it Trevor W, which is the name of my character in the movie, and it would be like the Trevor W story or something like that. But then we said, no, fuck it.
You can say that, but not on broadcast.
Okay, good. We just decided, why would I avoid the subject when just the title will say everything. So we just call it The Doorman.
He's with me, sir. It's okay, take care, please.
No. I gotta go in now.
Well, but you can't, with this hat, no, I can't. Sorry about that.
Why?
Because we have police is here, so it's... No,
just tell me your policy. What's your policy?
Sweetheart.
I love you, but you know what? Club, you know, the best people is inside.
I
have
darling,
to respect the code.
The
policy that you can't bring a hat and a backpack. It's not about...
Yeah, take your hat off. Is that
fantastic?
Well, if you lower your tone, maybe.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
Okay. Okay, but you can go that door. This door. Yes. You that way. The other way. To the window, right there.
The funny and interesting part of those nightclub doormans is that they not only do nightclubs. They are surrounded by a luxury lifestyle that drags them into a fashion shows, concerts, and many other different things that you can never imagine that those characters, you'll find them in there. And that's what a little bit of the movie is about too. It's not only the door of a club, but it's the door of a lifestyle, the door of a luxury style that people has no the access to get unless that you know that guy.
I usually try to make sure the restaurant has some tofu or something.
Tofu?
Tofu.
Who is this?
Tofu, it's like made from soy.
Is Sopranos Italian? They're Italian?
Everybody in the show is Italian, except me.
Okay, I could be Italian then. I could...
I play a Jewish psychiatrist, so...
Io parlo italiano.
Yeah?
If I go, Trevor W, Peter Batrandovich, I go with you, like, I'm your guy, you know, like, you just...
I can't take you with me when I'm shooting, because they...
Why not?
No, because they would like that. Come on over. How are you?
Hi.
I haven't
so
seen you for a while.
You.
How are you, sweetheart?
I'm good. I saw you across the room, but I saw these cameras here. I hope I'm not... Well,
they're shooting anything. They're shooting something about Trevor here.
How are you?
Trevor?
Hi.
Oh. What was your name again?
Oh, Denise.
Denise, right.
Yeah.
It was something with a D when I was a friend.
So was there a script, or it was all, you know, spontaneous?
It was a script for the whole movie, but everything was improvised. It wasn't dialed. We wrote the movie as a structure. We knew what was going to happen. We didn't write the dialogues. Dialogues and everything is improv.
So it's all improv from the people you interviewed in the movie.
The entire movie is improv.
You guys do this big, giant, you know, game, like the Mega Bowl, something like that.
The Mega Bowl.
Yeah.
It's the Super Bowl.
You guys do the Super Bowl.
The Super Bowl.
I also even bring this beer here, like you two, all these people. I don't know if you know, but they all know me. Imagine that, like I'm there and...
You want to be on the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Largest single-day sporting event, maybe available to 1 billion viewers around the world.
They all know me.
Let me go upstairs.
Yeah.
Let me talk it over with some of my bosses.
Dan Marino, Joe Montana, this guy Peyton,
Walter Payton.
Walter Payton, my friend.
Yeah, the problem is that the first two guys don't play anymore, and Walter, I don't know how well you know him, he died not too long ago.
Oh, really?
Yes.
What was the hardest part of making The Doorman?
The hardest part? Well, we were, there's some scenes that... we didn't necessarily had permission, and we were, for example, in Vegas, and we wanted to get a shot or something that we didn't script, but we were there, and as we went alone, we had some ideas that it might work. So we decided to go for it, even knowing that we didn't have permission. So we got into very places. We got into places that we shouldn't have gone without permission. And that was a little risky, but it was very worth it.
Ask me, for example, like, where I belong. Ask me that.
Trevor, where do you feel you belong?
That's a great question.
Let's go. I get to see you.
We just came with her. We're with her. Mm-hmm.
When I'm in front of a doorman, it's like I'm the owner in that moment.
You can't bring a hat and a backpack. It's not.
Can you send them to the door, please? The private class.
I know that sometimes people can get a little upset.
You get in a table. It's
our name right there.
They don't understand me.
Isn't that one, eh? Window. What?
In order to be a great doorman and a great, great presence, it's not just great pants, it's how you wear them. I hear people saying great pants for like a block away.
His work is legendary. Everybody knows who Trevor is. If you don't, I mean, you know, you're really not in the scene.
This city is all about connections. Like, yeah, I know people, you know, but more importantly, I know people who know me.
Trevor's a doorman, you know.
Oh.
And down at the club.
They have like 1,000 people saying, Trevor, 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 Trevor.
The ultimate metrosexual.
I'm your friend. I care about you. I like you.
Straight guys don't wear turquoise.
You're the man, Trevor.
Thank you, buddy.
Thank you, brother.
People might think that I'm unreachable, but I'm not. I'm not.
Hey, listen, I gotta call you about it, right?
Really into it.
And when we started following you, you were already on top of your game. We didn't know that you were gonna lose your job.
We just got around on that, isn't it? We don't really have to say that.
Make sure you go out and see The Doorman coming soon to a theater.
The Doorman coming soon. Bye bye.